All right, guys, this is going to be part two. We're going to put the cam in, timing components, and see what we can get done. I've already got my tensioners on there, new Mopar tensioners. These bolts are 10 millimeter, and they torque to 97 inch pounds. 97 inch pounds. And I did put blue Loctite on them already. Anything usually on these Gen 3 Hemis, internal wise on the timing component, components and oil pump, you put Loctite on it. I'm getting ready to put the cam in. I'm gonna put some lube on it and stuff, and we're gonna put that in. Okay, I've already lubed this up. We'll start putting it in the block now. All right, next we're going to put the cam plate, the thrust plate on the cam that holds the cam in, keeps it from coming out. Take this bolt back out. I just used the old bolt to put in there, and then a pair of vice grips. They sell tools for handles and stuff. Long bolt, extension, screwdriver usually works. Okay. This is the cam plate. These are the bolts. I'm gonna put Loctite on them. They are T30 star bit bolts. Just goes on like so. Run them all up before I torque them. I have a custom grind cam from Modern Muscle Extreme. I'm not going to go into specs because I don't want to give it out. It is not on their website. It is a custom grind. These torque to 106 inch pounds. 106 inch pounds. Do like a side-to-side pattern, cross pattern. All I'm gonna mark my bolts with a paint marker. That way I know I torqued them. Okay, now we're gonna put the cam phaser on and the timing chain. This is a new cam phaser from Mopar. I already put my limiter in it. This one, the cam that I have, is going to use a limiter. I've done this on a previous video, so go back and watch it. We'll go ahead. The mark, the little stud on the camshaft, the pin. I got to turn it to line it up and line the timing marks up. I've already got my number one cylinder up top dead center. Your number one cylinder on your Gen 3 Hemis is on the driver side front. And your gear down here is keyed, of course. And I highlighted the dot on it. That will point straight down, but on the VVT motors, it is off to the driver's side just a touch. That confuses a lot of people because the pre-Eagle stuff, non-VVT, is straight down. That is how it is on this. And your timing mark up here will point straight up to this hole. Spin the cam around a couple times. Just to get the oil spread out on the journals and stuff. There's a notch on the back of this gear. That is where that pin sits. And if this does not pop on there correctly and you go to torque it down, you will screw the world up. That alignment, that's all that is an alignment dowel. That does not turn the cam. That's only for alignment issues only, purposes only. A lot of people think that's how it grips on the gear. It's not. It's the torque and the pressure from the bolt. So if you don't torque it right, it will come loose. On my timing chain, it is new Mopar chain. I always use Mopar parts. I like to soak mine in a bag of oil. And let's see if I can show you. There is little marks on the chain. These two rectangles will straddle the top gear where it's marked. I'll put it on, then I'll show you guys. Goes just like that. Apply Loctite on your cam bolt. Can be a little tricky. just ran it up on there. Verify my timing marks. It will point straight up on the cam. Then down and off to the side a little bit on the bottom. That's how you line it up. Now, I put a bolt in the crankshaft back here against the engine stand. I'm going to wedge it so I can torque the cam bolt. Just like so. It torques to 90 foot-pound. And some of the manuals, it says like 73, 76. That is false. They are all 90 foot-pounds on the camshaft bolt. All right, we got that torqued. I'm gonna mark it with my paint marker. Now we're gonna pull our pin on our tensioner. That's how your timing marks will go. I did turn it a little bit, so they're not lined up perfect. Okay, I rotated it over a couple times just to double check my marks. Now your chain is not going to line back up the dots on it unless you turn it over like a million times or take it back off and redo it. But mark straight up. This mark here is where it's supposed to be. So let's put the oil pump and stuff on and go from there. Okay, on this oil pump, I got a Hellcat oil pump. And then put the Loctite on my bolts, and these bolts torque to 168 inch pounds. The sleeve in here that has lima sleeves on it. Should go on like so. Start all your bolts, then you can start torquing them. Torque to 168 inch pounds. Just run them up evenly until you get them torqued side to side. Okay, I'm gonna mark them with my paint marker. Okay, that is on. I'm gonna put the timing cover on. I already put the gasket and stuff on the back of the timing cover. It has alignment dowels on the sides of the block. Get all the bolts started before you start tightening them up. Get all of them started. Okay, we got all the bolts started. We're gonna run them up, then we'll torque them. There is a torque sequence on this, but really just side to side. Should be good. Torque them to 21 foot-pound. All right, we got all the bolts in, got them torqued. There's 12 bolts. All of them's 13 millimeters, except this one, it's a 15 millimeter. I'm gonna put the VVT sensor in now, it goes back here. Then we'll put the oil pan on. Got a new VVT sensor from Mopar. I put the new VVT sensor in, it just slides in, tighten it up. We'll spin it over and put the oil pan on it. Okay, I'm gonna put the silicone on it. You'll do it once more when you put the Wendy's tray on. Okay, let's set it on. Okay, and we'll put the pickup tube on. I put a new O-ring on it. Get the bolt started. Run it down, then we'll torque it 21 foot-pounds. paint marker. I know I tightened it up. All right, now we'll take and put the oil pan on. But first, we got to put the RTV silicone on these spots right here. This is where we put them before, but on top of this. We can set the oil pan on. Okay. Get all the bolts started. Big ones that goes in the back. So 15 millimeter, then the little ones are 10. It has a three step torquing procedure and a torque sequence, but basically just go side to side. Start in the middle and work your way out. Be starting and running up a little bit. I'm not tightening them up yet, just running them up. Get all the bolts in it before you start tightening it down. Okay, the first step is 44 inch pounds. The second is 39 foot pounds on the big bolts. Then the last step is 105 inch pounds. I'll finish torquing this and get back with you. All right, guys, got the oil pan all on and torqued. Again, those torque specs are 44 inch pounds, then 39 foot pounds on the big bolts, then 105 inch pounds. Right now, I'm installing my ATI 18% overdrive dampener. I've already got the hub on, getting ready to pin it. I just took the old bolt and got this started, the hub started, just pegged it on barely, then took the bolt in it and just ran it up, put tension on it, just slightly tap on the side of it with a hammer, and just kept doing that till I got it all the way seated. I've got a Torque Storm pin kit. Others were, if they say sell ATI ones, it really don't matter. I've already put the tool in here. I'm getting ready to drill it. So we'll get this drilled. All right, we got it drilled. Already put the pins in. Just drill it. It comes with, you have to look online for instructions on their the Torque Storm pin kit, but the small ones go in for the Hemis. Just measure your drill bit, mark it, drill it. Just get them started and take a punch and just drive them on in. I got an ARP bolt that I'm going to use. On your bolt, put a little bit of silicone around the washer, because sometimes in between the crank and the hub, a little bit of oil will seep through. And Loctite your bolt. This torques to 130 foot-pounds. Just going to do it with the impact and then check the torque on it. Let's get this bolt in there. Lock the crankshaft so I can torque it with a torque wrench. Alright, we're going to torque this 130 foot-pounds. Okay, got the big part of the dampener on, got my bolts ran up. I'm going to torque them. These star bit bolts go to 16 foot-pounds. Make sure you put Loctite on all these. And the 12-point bolts go to 28 foot-pounds. Just then torque them in a star pattern. May have to lock the crank again because it's trying to spin on me. I'll go over them one more time and I'll mark them. All right, got everything installed. This is it for part two. I'll probably make a part three for the heads, but that won't be as long. That's all for this video. Like, share, and subscribe. Thanks.